Tēnā koutou katoa, nau mai anō ki hunting Aotearoa. Hei tēnei wiki tātou haere ki te pito rāki te o waere ki rohe. I reira tūtake atu ki ngā teina tuakana a Alex, lawako Frank Laughlin. Mā rāua tātou e whakaako me pēhea te puhitia mai runga waka topa topa. He kaitoranga apu I mua Edwin Perry, ā, mana tātou e hari te aru aru I te takiwā o Wairarapa. Nō reira, keri te mai, he hōtaka whakahihiko I te ngākau, hei te haire. Ka haere tātou ki Opotiki, ki reira tūtaki atu ki ngā teina, ki a Alex, lawako Frank Laughlin. G'day, mate.
G'day, mate.
Good hell.
Good day for flying, eh?
Yeah, not too bad.
The old Hughes 500?
Yeah.
Is that your choice, your preference, or not?
Well, it is for this sort of work, eh? It is for shooting. It's a good machine.
What actually got you into the old chopper hunting and all that? Because, mate, you've been all around the country now, and you're the first bloody, one of the first Māori operators we've seen and first Māori shooters we've seen. What actually got you started?
I've been a hunter since I was a young fella with the old man, and the only way to keep that up and make a profession of it was to become a pilot, so had a crack at it, and here I am today.
Still going?
Well, yeah, just.
What about you, Frank? What got you shooting out of choppers?
Oh, more than likely just got, the opportunity was there, and I thought, well, why not? It's something I'd never done before, and yeah, quite enjoyed it. It's a bit of a thrill.
Said if I was a shooter, they'd probably only get 2 deer on, but with you, they'd probably get 10 on.
Probably wouldn't get off the ground. With no deer.
So where are we heading this morning, gentlemen?
I reckon we'll head down to the around the Motu area, down the Motu River, and we'll fly up the Manga Tintara, work that catchment, and over into the Haupatapata and back to the bridge, and hopefully we'll get a couple of deer by then.
Okay. Shall I be the shooter?
Oh, mate, you probably look better in the back, bro.
Oh, co-piloting.
Nah, you up in the back.
Okay, my bro. Putaku tino hia hia kia noho au hei kai pupuhi. Engari, me wai hopea mā ngā tino tohu ngai nei mahi te whakatūtuki. Mā kūpea hei kai hautū waka topo topo ata hoki ngā mai. Ko Alex te tangata tohunga rawa o tēnei takiwā ki ta hautū waka topo topo. Ka hore he tangata kei tū atu I aia mō ngā mahi hopu me te patutia. Ko enei tokorua anake pea ngā tuakana Māori o Aotearoa whānui mō te mahi hopu me te patutia. Ka timata te hairere ki ngā whenua teitei ma te awa motu, hei whakaohorere I ngā rōpūtia, ka puta mai, ka patua. Ka pau te tukau miniti ka kite he roputia. He pupuhi kei te haire. Come on, Howie. Have a fucking good day now. Little Dumai coffee there, bro. 82 months, man, this morning. I've never seen that bloody mini deer before. So what other purpose do you use your choppers for?
Our main work is agricultural spraying and flying recreational pig hunters and deer hunters into the forest parks.
And you say like plenty of game now than there was in the old days, because they haven't dropped 1080 in there, or they have?
No, there's no 1080 up in here. No, none whatsoever. But there's talk of it. They're always talking about the best animal control weapon that they have available to them is 1080.
I think we're the only country still using it.
Yeah, probably are.
And the old pork, still plenty of pork running around.
Plenty of pork there, what?
Need a bloody hinu on there.
Yeah, not too bad, eh?
Good for the old arteries,
that
bugger.
Oh, yeah, mate, that's the bugger. Yeah, no good eating a skinny one.
So how long ago did you start
flying?
Getting into the air? Yeah.
Started flying in 1988. I started flying.
Was it just a fly or into the deer?
Straight into the deer, yeah.
You think the market will open up again?
Yeah, well, it should do. There's no reason why not, eh? There's no reason why not. I think that the biggest problem that the industry has today is securing a reliable market. In the past, the prices have fluctuated. Mm. Where it's economical to go out and shoot out of a helicopter, and then all of a sudden, for one reason or another, that the price has fallen away, and then it becomes uneconomical. Right at the moment, there hasn't been any serious venison recovery go on throughout New Zealand for probably the last 5-6 years. I mean, seriously, there's been a few marks that have popped up from time to time, and you've been able to, and the market's demanded it maybe 400 or 500 deer, so we go out and shoot our quota of that 500, and once the quota's been filled, animals have been processed and they've been exported, and that's the end of it. You just sort of sit back and wait until such time as there's another order comes through.
Hey Frank, is the choice of weapons still the same as it was back in the old days, or you've gone up a calibre?
No, it's pretty much the same. Went to a shotgun for a while, but back with the Armalite again, it's a lot cleaner shots and stuff like that, eh? Yeah. With the buckshot, you've got a bigger pattern. Sometimes the old bloomin' come back into the middle of the back now and again if it's a long shot. But yeah, back with the old Armalite.
For people that, you know, like you say, you fly hunters in, are they able to sort of shoot from the chopper as well?
No, not at all. It's a pretty specialised game, being a shooter on a helicopter. There's a lot of hazards out there when you're operating.
Yeah.
To go and throw somebody that's never done it before into that seat and put them in that environment, it's a recipe for disaster. It takes a fair bit of training to be competent, and also to make the pilot feel comfortable about flying with somebody that's capable of carrying out the operation safely, you know.
So I suppose there's a big trust factor with the pilot, you know, the camaraderie.
Oh, yeah.
With the
Yeah, definitely. You have to be a team, you have to work together, you have to think together. When you hit a mob, you need to, it's up to the pilot to manoeuvre the animals in a direction so that you give your shooter the best opportunity to clean the mob up. Hey, sure, you're not going to get the whole lot, but you've got to give them that opportunity so that you manoeuvre and work those deer into an area or into a situation where your shooter gets the best is able to get the best opportunity to knock over as many as he can out of the mob.
Oh, we've had a bit of break. We've got three on the back of the trailer now. How about we clean up and clean John Balls some more?
Hei muri inga whakatairanga, he rerere anō, he pupuhi anō kei te haere me ngā tūngāne Lachlan. Kei konei a Adam me ngā tohu waruwaru o te wiki. Katahi katai atu tātou ki te waira rapa, ki reira aruaru haere anō. Kei runga waka topo topo anō a Alex rawa ko Frank e whakaatū mai ana i a rāua pūkenga ki te hoputia. Me ki pēa ko Alex te kai hautū waka topo topo pai ake o ngā kai hautū katoa kua ki te eau. Aha kua te kaha neke neke o te waka topo topo me te tāhuri o taku puku ki hai au I paku a wanga wanga mo taku oranga. Kātahi te tino toki tēnei ki ona mahi. Aha ko te wahangu o te tokorua nei I te nuingo te wā, ka kitea he momo kōrero anō ki wāinga I a rau. He hono ngā ahine ngaro pea teina ki te tuakana, tuakana ki te teina. Ki te pātai koe ki te tokorua nei he aha te mea nui ki a pai tā kōrua mahitahi, he whakapono ki tō hoa te whakautu.
Bit of venison there, gentlemen.
Yeah, there sure is, eh?
Bloody wouldn't believe it, mate, the amount of bloody animals up there we saw today.
Yeah, then you went.
These are the unfortunate ones that never got away. Our mate's eye coming bloody cracking at the end of the day, eh? Thank you, mate.
You're welcome, Butch.
I'll be back.
Okay, mate.
At the whānau, if you want to go for a little hunt in Opotiki, just look up Central Helicopters and ask for Alex Laughlin. And he'll guarantee you'll see one, and it's up to your eye whether you get one. Hey, mate.
That's the one.
Anything like Frank's eye, you'll probably get about half a dozen. Something. So who shout is it? Mine?
You'll shout, bro.
Okay, bro. E te iwi nau mai hoki mai ki tēnei wahanga o hunting Aotearoa. Kōrero awhina, Hunting and Fishing New Zealand Tip of the Week. Tā māua mahi, whakatika pū. Adam, how important is that for any hunter?
Well, it's very important, Howie. Like before we go on any trip, that we make sure our rifle is shooting accurately and our scope is aligned. So one of the first things we want to make sure is that our rings and bases are tight and secure on the rifle. We need to set up our target at 25 yards.
Right.
Okay, this is an aligning target. And then from then on, we can make sure that our scope is aligned and shooting accurately as we extend the range out. So easy way to do that, handy little gadget, okay, a laser rangefinder, if you're lucky to have one, makes things life a lot easier.
Also helps have a good eye.
Helps have a good eye.
That's right.
So we need to clean that rifle, make sure that barrel's nice and clean. Okay, Howie, we need to bring this across here and up. So we're shooting for this target. We're in alignment there. So we'll go back to the scope and we'll adjust it. Bring it across and up.
Right, Howie, on the target there, our rounds, when they hit the target, were down and to the left. So we need to adjust this. So we'll grab the old Gerber multi-tool here. Now, our windage is on the side and our elevation is on the top. So what we need to do, because this is quarter minute of angle, so we'll need to click these back probably at least 8 times there, and then we'll bring the top one back up just a couple of times there. And then what we'll need to do then is set off another couple of rounds to make sure that we're getting to where we want our targets to fire at.
Right, have another blast. Go and check it out, mate.
Let's have a look.
Let's put it more back to centre, mate.
Yep.
What do we do now to shed it at 100 yards?
Right, all we need to do is probably crank it up. This is a 100 yard target. Each little square here is a quarter minute of angle. Okay, so what we need to do, because we're at 25 yards, take it another 75 yards, 3 clicks, should on average do the job for us.
Not bad grouping for 100 yards, mate. Anything in a scope should go down.
It's not going to survive that, mate.
That's right. And there you have it. Whether it be pig, whether it be deer, you can take on whether it be anywhere. Koe nei te kōrero awhina, o tēnei wiki. Let's go hunting.
Let's go.
Kei te pāmu o te mai tātou, pātata ana ki te tuku tai rāwhiti o Wairarapa.
E te whānau kua tā māhau ki te rohe o Wairarapa, ki te tūtaki atu ki tētahi tangata, e kai ngākau ana te whakangaupua. Hara mai. G'day, mate.
Dave, how are you?
Long time,
yeah,
buddy.
Long time no see, mate.
I always wondered what happened to the best Māori politician in New Zealand.
Thank you, thank you, thank you for those compliments.
You could have top dog job by now.
Well, you never know. In that game, I'm sure there's some gaps still there.
So how long have you been hiding out here?
Yeah, well, you know, since I left politician or didn't get back in the last election, I've been pretty busy. Back here in the Wairarapa and back into Marsden where I'm born and bred, played my rugby here. And obviously all my work skills are eventuated from this area. And, you know, politics is one area of my life, but I did enjoy it. And I've been here in Marsden now since 2003. After spending 4 years in Adelaide working for a company in recycling.
Who actually got you into pig hunting?
Well, we've been pig hunting out at a place at about 35 k's out of Marsden since we were 10. And my father, who's still alive, was European, he's 88, was keen on pig hunting. And of course, we used to go pestering him and go pig hunting. Sometimes we'd wag school just to go. But and then it programmed on, and I, 60s and early 70s, and I hunted. I mean, I hunted for those days in the 60s and made good money. I mean, I could earn $300 or $400 a week out of just meat hunting, and that was better than shearing 300 sheep a day. So, and of course, in the latter years, my brother Ian, who farms on the family farm, is mad on pig hunting, so find time. You've got to find time. It's good exercise. And what I like today is see all the young guys that are out hunting. Yeah. Damn good, you know.
Well, mate, I'm ready and keen as for a hunt.
Well, I just know the right spot, Howie. It's a place called Tiamai Station. There's a couple of young guys there who are working on a farm, Simon Meredith and young Mike. And I'm pretty sure we'll get a pig there today.
Sounds good to me. Let's go and catch a pig.
Mate. Okay, mate.
Ko te teihana o te mai tēnei. E whenua koraha, engari, kua roa te hunga kāinga e taitai ana mai ki konei whakangau poaka puihi nunui. I tēnei rā, ke ta whai atu tātou i taua momo poaka. Ko Edwin Perry tētahi, kaore e tino whakaaro hia hei tauira pai o te kai whakangau poaka. I te nuinga o te wā, mau hūtu, mau neketai ke tēnei tangata.
Our pig's been into the cow this morning. Dogs are shot up here. So hopefully he might be in.
Ka timata ngā mahi aruarua, Edwin, iai tai tamatonu ana I raro I ngā tohu a tona pāpā, a tona kraua, a ona mātua hoki. I enei rā, ko Edwin kē te kai tohu e whakaako ana I ngā Simon, rauako Michael, ki ngā tikanga o te whakangau poaka. Kua here a ngā maukaki ki ngā kuri kia ngā wari aki ai te rapu ina ngaro rātou. Ko te tumanako kia rongo ake te auau a te kuri, te tangi a te poaka rānei. E whai ake nei, ka kitea te pōka nunu e ngā kuri. Yee-hee! Kei te teihana o te mai I te Wairara pāno tata.
They're still moving a bit.
But they haven't moved out of that area though, have they?
No.
Yeah, they're still in that area there.
Kauru tātou ki te ngahere matatengi ki te rapu I ngā kuri. Ki te kite ngā kuri, ka kite he pōka tā mātou e whakapono ana. Oh, e taukiri e! Kua kitea! Oh, te rahi hoki o tēnei!
Get it over, right?
I'll grab it.
Jeez, he's heavy. Ko te āhua nei, kua roa kē ngā kuri e ngau ana ia ia. Kia horo te whakatūtuki ngā mahi, ka riro mā Edwin tērā.
Oh, well, we got there, eh? Thanks, Simon and Mike.
Whew. He's made it the old, wired up a football team for it like this, he'd be back in the first division, eh? Ready scrap, eh? They all scrap like this around here?
Well, missed it, dude.
Actually, I think this has been a good, I mean, the dog's had him for at least 20 minutes, and when we got here, he was really going for it, so, no, a lot of pigs here in this particular area.
What's this place called?
It's TMI Station, originally TMI Station, and now it's been broken up into four farms that are very well known in the 50s and 60s for pig hunting. One of the chaps that was a shepherd on TMI Station, Doug Leach, who's now was killed here 3 years ago in a motorbike accident, caught over 600 pigs in a year. So he's known as the Crocodile Dundee of TMI Station, so you know.
And this is bound for the table?
This one's bound for the table, and it's a good eater. And what I do, you know, I mean, because a lot of our old people now have moved from the rural sector into the urban, don't always get wild pork. And and my brother and I always drop some off to them when we go back into town, and it's always appreciated, you know, so.
Well, at least we can do for these younger fellas is I'll hold the legs. You can do the surgery and then we'll make a clear track for them to take it back out. What do you reckon?
That's a good idea.
Good idea.
We'll find the track out and
looks and we'll like buy Mike, the beer
Mike
for the market.
Mike looks the fittest, doesn't
he? Yeah, I reckon. Right? He'd be worried.
But this guy's a shearer. He might have a bit more stamina to get out of the steep bit, so.
All right, whip the guts out and head
okay,
home.
Okay, let's go. Thanks, guys.
Nō reira, ka pērā rawa te mahi. Ka heria te puaka, ka tehi ka pikauria e te tahi o te hunga rangatahi. Tata atu ki te tihi o te puke, ka pikaua te poaka Edwin. Yeah, ka tahi te tangata kaha ko ia. He whakaroana ngā tamaki a timata ngā mahi hunuhunu. Kaore he wāhi paiake i tā tahi mo e nei mahi. He maha ngā tā whāwhāo, he whakakāhi, he rangi huarere pai hoki. Ka hikina ake te poake e Simon, rau ako Mike, ā ka timata ngā mahi hunuhunu. Kā rau e wā kōrua mahi. Yeah. I reckon we should... I think the boys are almost done, they might head back to town.
I think we'll head back to town.
Spark that barbecue up.
Spark that barbecue up and we'll obviously let young Mike Meredith go and get some powers for us.
Sounds good to me.
Take them back home.
Tau kē ngā mahi o tēnei rā. Kua uru ki te wāo, kua takahia hoki ngā onepu o tātahi. Here's the boys.
What a great day, guys. Powers too.
Oh, you kept to your plan, mate. Hell. Kept to your plan.
Yep.
Well, Howie, been a good day, mate.
Good day. We got the pork.
Pork.
We got the powers.
What are you going to take?
Well, actually, I might cut off the flaps of the pork, put those in the barbies, and I'll leave you with the powers.
Yeah, I'll do the powers.
Sound like a good plan?
Yeah, I think we'll chuck them out and give them a bit of a tap with the old hammer.
That's us.
That's East Coast style.
Just one word of advice. Style. One word of advice. Next year, go high. Prime Minister, and I'll be your deputy. What do you reckon?
Yeah, shake on that, brother.
That's us, mate.
Thank you.
Right, let's whip these flaps out. You take the powers, and I'll do these flaps.
Hei tēnā wiki kei te tua whenua o ahitereire anō tātou. Me taku matua Dick Maika, ka aruaru haere tātou me tētahi o te tangata whenua o reira. Nō reira hoki mai anō a tērā wiki, i runga i a hunting o te aroa.
Very important to clean it after.
E te iwi nau mai hoki.
Yeah.
E te iwi nau mai hoki mai ki tēnei wahanga o